Hi, this is Rose from Dream Center Las Vegas, and I'm going to speak to you tonight about trials, tribulations, and triumph. So before we get going, let's just ask the Lord to come in and take control of this service. Father, we just thank you for your presence. Holy Spirit, we welcome you. You are so welcome in everything. We thank you that you work in and through us to your honor and glory. Pray that you would just put your words in my mouth, Lord, tonight. Let us hear directly from heaven. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Trials, tribulations, and triumph. Let's go to John 16:33, and Jesus is speaking, and he says, I have told you these things so that in me you may have perfect peace and confidence. In the world you have tribulation and trials and distress and frustration, but be of good cheer. And the Amplified says, take courage and be confident, certain and undaunted, for I have overcome the world. And the Amplified also says, I have deprived it of power to harm you and have conquered it for you. Good news. Jesus is all about good news. Hallelujah. You know, we have seen devastation in our nation. We have seen our landmarks being torn down, the riots, and everything that is not of God going on. This is not a war between the anarchists, the people that are out there doing what they're doing. This is not about them. It's about the spirit realm. It's about Satan using them to tear down America, because this is a nation that is founded on God. And our money says, in God we trust. And that's who our trust is in. Hallelujah. But Satan hates that, and so he wants to bring us down any way he can. You know, and it can be extremely frustrating and distressing. But I believe God's saying it's time to stop looking at what's going on around us and start looking at what his word says and what he's called us to do and to be in this day, in this time, in this hour. Do you think that this was a surprise to him, that all this was going to go on? No, of course not. But he has put us here to stand in the gap, to be the one that he has called to speak forth his word and bring light and bring peace and bring joy to this world. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes people have said, oh, we just need to be in the church. We just need to sing three fast and two slow songs and sit in our pews. Well, I'll tell you what, when you sit in your pew just so long, you start smelling. That's what pew says. But God has not called us to be complacent or stagnant. You know, we need to be in the river, and the river flows. And when it flows into a lake, unless there's an outlet, that lake becomes very stagnant, sort of like the Dead Sea. It really does smell. But God meant it to flow freely from us to someone else, from the body to the outside world, to bring them in. He would that none would perish, but all would come to a knowledge of salvation in him. Amen. Hallelujah. I believe it's time for us to get up out of our couch, out of our house, and to rise and shine and let his light flow through us to the world. It says in Isaiah 60, verses 1 and 2, arise from the depression, this is the Amplified, arise from the depression and prostration in which circumstances have kept you. Rise to a new life. Shine, be radiant with the glory of the Lord, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and dense darkness all peoples, but the Lord shall arise upon you, and his glory shall be seen in you. That's the good news. Hallelujah. You know, when Moses came down from Mount Moriah with the word of God, with the Ten Commandments, his whole body shone. His clothes were shiny. His face were aglow, to the point where he had to put on a mask. Sound familiar? They couldn't look at his face. He had to cover it because they would be blinded by the brilliance of the glory of God that was on him. The same glory, the same God that raised Christ from the dead, that same God is in us and shines through us. We can't see it sometimes. It doesn't matter. It's there. And we have to know that God has put it in us for a reason and a purpose, and that's to reach out and bless others. Hallelujah. The enemy has tried to keep us down and hidden in our little homes. He's thrown everything at us but the kitchen sink, so to speak. And he always, always, always overplays his hand. And he has this time as well. The enemy is always trying to stop what God has done and what he is doing on the face of this earth. I mean, our country was humming along, but it's not just about the United States. This COVID-19 was global, and they want, the globalists want medical to be global, the banking to be global, the government to be global. But I am here to tell you that we live in one nation under God. And that's who we trust. In God we trust is what our money says, and that's where we are today. This nation has done more for the world than any other nation. Our hearts are full of compassion because God has put that in us because we are his nation. To reach out with medical needs, with food, with digging wells for people, to get water, all kinds of things that we have given upcoming nations money and help in all kinds of areas because we are and have been a giving nation. We love God's people, and everyone was created by him. Amen. No matter what your nationality, no matter what your ethnic origin is, it doesn't matter. When I look at someone, I see them by the Spirit. I don't see the color of their skin. I don't see what they're wearing many times. I simply see their spirit, and I commune, my spirit communes with theirs, and I see God in them. And that's all that matters. Hallelujah. Or their lack of Jesus. And then I am filled with compassion for them, and I want to lead them to someone that can help them, and that's Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. It's never been about us, but God in us. Ephesians 6:12 says that, the scripture, we're not wrestling against flesh and blood. It's not about the people that are doing these things. It's about the enemy working through them, and that's who we come against. We don't come against the people. They don't even know they're being used for the most part. But Ephesians 6:12 says, and I'm going to read it, "For we are not wrestling with flesh and blood, contending only with physical opponents, but against the depositions, against the powers, against the master spirits who are the world rulers of this present darkness, against the spirit forces of wickedness in the heavenly supernatural sphere." That's who we wrestle against. It's always about the supernatural, angelic forces versus satanic forces. And they come together and they clash. When we pray, God sends out his heavenly host to do warfare, to do the battle. Hallelujah. This is a battle that's been going on from the beginning of time between good and evil. It's just manifest very much so right now in our country. And so we have a position to play in this game. Hallelujah. You know, if you're just sitting at home, you have to consider what other people are looking at. If you're just looking at CNN, MSNBC, NBC, ABC, so on, you're gonna see the same thing in all the different channels, because they have talking points. Fox News, not so much. They are definitely more truthful in their reporting. When I was a child, a young person growing up, we trusted the reporters because everything was verified before they reported it. They wanted to know that that was the truth. Not so much today, in today's world. They look at something, and if it's exciting, if it's depressing, whatever, they will report it, and before they even verify it. So we have to be careful. We have to be the guardians of our ear gates, our eyes gates, our eye gates, so that what comes out of our mouth is what God is saying and not what the reporters or anyone else is saying. So we have to use discernment in what we subject ourselves to, what we allow ourselves to listen to, and we need to be hearing from God Himself. But God has given us discernment. We must guard what we listen to. As I said, we are warring against a defeated foe. Jesus defeated Satan 2,000 years ago at the cross. Hallelujah. Satan thought he was winning. Oh, I've got him where I want him now. He's dying. This is awesome. But like boxers in a match, when one goes down, the referee will count 1, 2, 3, up to 10, and then he calls him out. But when God started counting, he counted from 10, 9, 8, 7, and Satan said, wait, you're counting the wrong way. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Jesus is the victor. Hallelujah. He was triumphed over him then, and he does it today as well. Satan is a defeated foe, but he's still trying to win back the people that don't know Jesus Christ, because we're all made in the image and likeness of God, and he hates that. That's the worst thing that he could imagine, and so he wants to bring us down. He came to kill, steal, and destroy. That hasn't stopped. That's still his agenda. But we have the authority to come against those spirits and take control of the atmosphere. When you walk by, the atmosphere changes and people look around and they want to know what has happened. Well, the glory that is in you from God, the same of Father that raised Jesus Christ from the dead, lives in us, the same Spirit. And so we have the Spirit of Christ in us, the Spirit of God, and He is victorious over the enemy. So nothing can come against us and succeed. All authority was given to Jesus when He overcame Satan at the cross, and He gave it to us. And I know I've quoted this scripture before, but it's one of my favorites. It's Luke 10:19. He says, "Behold, I have given you authority and power to trample on snakes and scorpions." That's evil spirits that's working behind these people. Snakes and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy. That's awesome. "And nothing shall in any way harm you." So I know that we're getting, we're getting towards the end times. I mean, we are in the end times. We're getting towards the end. It's like 11:30 or 11:45. Time is short. I know we're ready to go, but who are we leaving behind? Is it a neighbor? Is it a relative? I'm going up to see my 90-year-old sister shortly, and she doesn't know the Lord. And I'm on a mission because I know that time is short for her. But God, He is so faithful. And I know that she's going to come to know the Lord in this trip. So I thank God for that. But is it a relative? Is it a neighbor? Is it a coworker that's going to be left behind because we failed to reach out and touch them? We failed to give them the good news. I want to challenge you tonight. Go for it. What have you got to lose? You know, your reputation, if we give everything to God, God, you can have it all. Every part of my world, there is nothing I want to retain, nothing worth retaining for myself. I give it to you. So if I'm ridiculed or whatever, if I'm not received, it's okay, because they're not rejecting me, they're rejecting you, which is not okay. But that's the way it is. We win or we lose by what we choose. We always have a choice, but it is our choice and our extreme pleasure to go and be the ambassador for Christ, especially in this day, in this hour, when it looks so very dark. But in Psalms 47:1, I love this Psalms. But in Psalms 47:1, it says, we will sing with a shout of triumph to our God because we have the victory. Oh, clap your hands, all you people. Shout to God with the voice of triumph and songs of joy. See, when someone comes to the Lord, when you lead someone to the Lord, that is so exciting. Wow, because you know their life has changed forever for the better. They will now have not just life, but abundant life in Jesus Christ. And so I would challenge you, just take a step. Just take one step. Cry out God. Trust Him to do what He said He's going to do. He's never failed me yet. And I've been with Him for a lot of years. I see His miracles. He amazes me all the time. And I know He will you too. And fill you with His joy and His peace so that we do not have to be afraid of anything, but we can face the enemy and face him down. He is a defeated foe, as I said, and we have the triumph. We have the victory. So, Father, I just thank you for your word. I thank you for the encouragement, Lord. I thank you for the challenge. It's exciting to serve you, Lord, more exciting than anything else. And so, Father, I pray that you would just ignite a fire, a new fire within us to go and do what you've called us to do. We worship you tonight. We thank you for everything that you do in and through us. And we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.